Namaste. This is Seshu from Hamsika Academy, welcoming you back for learning grade 7, the topic New Kings and Kingdom. We already did a video on this one. So this is the second session or second video lecture on the same topic, which we are going to discuss the case study of Rashtrakutas. Let us discuss them. Let me share my screen. The case study, as we discussed in the previous video lecture, that we are going to do on Rashtrakutas. So we have taken an image of Danti Durga, which is taken from a website of tutorialspoint.com. So let us get into the topic. So initially, the Rashtrakutas were subordinates to the Chalukyas of Karnataka. So as we discussed in the previous video, that they used to work as warrior chiefs and the king used to recognize them. So here we are looking at that one, the first point itself, that Rashtrakutas were subordinates to the Chalukyas of Karnataka. Danti Durga has been a very powerful subordinate to Karnataka's Chalukyas or Chalukyas of Karnataka. So what did he do? He wanted to declare himself as an independent ruler. But Danti Durga was not a Kshatriya by birth. Actually, we have the Chaturvarna system, which was written by Manu Dharma Shastra Manu, where we learned about the Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, Sudras, which were Varnas. But over a period of time, they came to be considered as by birth as a caste. So here we can see one such example of Danti Durga being considered as a non-Kshatriya. So in order to declare his independence and also to change himself as establishing himself as a ruler, he performed a ritual called Hiranya Garbha. What is that? Hiranya Garbha. So once he is doing this ritual, can he do it by himself? No. He has to take the help of the Brahmana. So Brahmanas used to play a key role during that particular point of time, even today also. So when they were doing this ritual, he took the help of Brahmins and he did this ritual called Hiranya Garbha, which is like, Garbha means the womb of the earth, the golden womb of the earth. So once you do this ritual, what will happen then? That will lead to rebirth, reborn. So you are born as a non-Kshatriya. So you will become a Kshatriya person now. You will be recognized as a Kshatriya for a non-Kshatriya if you perform a ritual called Hiranya Garbha with the help of Brahmin, which makes you to take rebirth again. So Danti Durga wants to establish his independence and also establish a kingdom. So for him, he thought the best one is to do a ritual called Hiranya Garbha. When you do the ritual of Hiranya Garbha, definitely you will be considered as a rebirth, and automatically the other kings and the kingdoms will come to know about the news and will consider you as a new ruler. So he wants to establish himself as a new king, start a new kingdom and also ascertain his independence. So all these activities can be completed by doing the ritual of Hiranya Garbha, which gives him the rebirth status, which is like a Kshatriya for a non-Kshatriya. That's how the Rashtrakutas have emerged as the rulers and established a kingdom. So in this video, we discussed about how the Rashtrakutas were initially the subordinates to Chalukyas of Karnataka. Danti Durga in the mid 8th century has ascertained his independence and also performed Hiranyagarbha ritual with the help of the Brahmana. So with this ritual, he becomes a Kshatriya. Though he is born as a non-Kshatriya, he will emerge as a Kshatriya and a new king now. So that is for the learning, and for the notes, children can copy the mind map, the case study of Rashtraputas. You can write in small words so that it will be easy to remember for you. The subordinates to the Chalukyas: Danti Durga, Hiranyagarbha, the ritual. What will that ritual do? It will make you to take rebirth, and then you are a non-Kshatriya, will be considered as a Kshatriya who performs this ritual. Thank you. Thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe.